last week on the Sound Barrier Field Blog.
So I just took a shot and missed low. It's just super thick in here. We lost Bud and we were just trying to search for him. Okay. So I found the buck. Just got him to the processor. Hopefully the meat's good. He was slightly smelly. But I did the best we could with that. I'm back in the spot where I saw the big buck last night. We got a little questionable wind. South, southeast. West is best here. Saw a guy coming in out in the field getting here. Don't think he'll be an issue. Guys are hunting back here. And in the field where all the deer have been going, the landowners were, when I was packing up to get out here, the landowners were at a weed whacker and were getting a blind ready or something out there, so I don't know if they're gonna hunt there or not. So who knows what I have at night, right? I debated on leaving because we're getting some east wind thrown in here. And I really don't want to screw this up, but I think we're okay if it stays primarily south. And hopefully that big buck is still in here and he might walk a little closer this time. We'll see. Okay, I'm back in here where I shot the buck last weekend and saw a little buck at first light right underneath me. Went up the other way along this opening here. Since then I haven't seen anything. The wind is supposed to be southwest, but it's more southeast and that ain't helping. But it's a good bedding area. Last week it didn't heat up till a little bit later in the morning. We'll stick it out. Spot. Already bumped one and putting up the stand. I'm getting in kind of late. Super high winds. But I'm on this huge scrape and rub line I found. Lots of fresh rubs and big scrapes. I'm up the stand. Put a trail camera down there. We'll see what shows tonight, maybe tomorrow morning. I'll probably hunt it tomorrow morning. Three or four good trails that come through here, and that scrape line comes right up through here, so I know they're traveling this. Thank you.
Yeah.
So I just shot a big, big Michigan public land buck. He came running down this trail where there's a ton of scrapes we found yesterday, a ton of scrapes and big rubs. I sat up here yesterday in the wind and it happened just like that. He just came running in. I heard him and I heard him, saw him come running and I saw how big he was. He came in here at 15 yards. I grunted and stopped him and shot.
Yeah.
I just saw him go down. Oh my gosh. My season's over in Michigan. Two public land bucks. It's October 20th. Oh, wow. I cannot believe that. Thank you, God. I cannot believe that. There's my arrow. He came from up in there. There's a scrape line and trail right there. Bunch of scrapes. Came running right down in through here. I grunted and stopped him right there. He's just over there. Just up in there. There's the result right there. Right up there. Oh man, that's the biggest buck I have ever shot. Fat buck. Oh my goodness, man. You gotta be kidding me. Wide, good shot. Look at this monster. Biggest, well, for sure my biggest Michigan buck. I didn't really expect to see this. On public land, you work hard enough and you find them. That's the hard part.